Go ahead.
Okay, as along with the flex tab conversion, I promised some people I would show how to rebuild a Remington breech bolt. I mean, a Remington breech bolt now is $106.95. There's very little you're ever going to have to do to this that you would need a new one. Okay? We're going to start with this old Wingmaster breech bolt. All the parts are identical to the modern breech bolt, except one, and that is the firing pin retractor spring. And that's this spring in here. Am I throwing you out of focus, Jason?
No, we're okay. I'm just zooming in. There we go.
All right. The modern spring was designed to stop the breakage they were experiencing with the old spring. In the old spring, and we just spent 20 minutes looking for the one that I had here a while ago, the coils are consistent through the entire spring. But when I pull this out and show you the new spring, you're going to see that in the center of the firing pin retractor spring, the coils are compressed together in the center. That's how you know it's a modern spring, and that's the one you want in your own wing, your old Wingmasters. Okay? So, all the other parts are the same as these modern breech bolts. So, to get to the firing pin retractor spring, what we're going to do, we're going to drive this pin out, and we're going to drive it out from the top. Okay? You just put two sticks together. I got a jig for it, but I'm going to keep with my promise of using, not using gunsmith tools on these videos. So you would set it like this. You have a punch that fits that hole. I keep old parts. They work real good. I can actually do this with this old firing pin. You could use a old screwdriver. You could even use a nail, as long as it fits in the hole, okay? You're going to drive this pin out from the top down, all right? And you're going to see this pin come out, and you're going to see that it's flared on one side, and it's rounded off on the other side. Remember that. You're going to keep your punch, your nail, or whatever you're using in. Then you're just going to put your finger over the firing pin and pull that out, and slowly let the firing pin come out. All right? Now the firing pin's going to come out. The spring falls out. And the locking block falls out. This is the modern spring. And he'll get a still of that closer. Okay? This is a locking block. Now there is a little pin in here. So this pin drives out and in. So for any reason that thing was to break off, you could pull it out, get that part from Remington, and reinstall that pin. Okay? And that's pretty much all your breech bolt right there, except for the extractor, and we'll cover that in a minute. Alright? So, you took the old spring out, you're going to install the new one. So what we're going to do is, and first I want to show you something. Practice this. Front of the bolt, locking block goes to the front. Alright, if you come in from the back, you're fine. It pivots. Alright, but if you come in from the front like that, it wedges. It will not move. Okay? So, come in from the back. Your pin's going to go in this cutout here. Drop it in. There you go. Okay? Then what you want to do, you're going to drop your spring in, and I like to come through, I like to come through the front with something and capture the spring with that. That way that holds that spring in place. And then I'm going to take my firing pin and come through the back and straight through the spring, okay? And by having that there, that allowed me to get my firing pin into that hole, all right? Now, if you look at this firing pin, see this cutout right there? you got to look down through here and make sure that cutout's lined up. All right? Or else this pin's not going to go in. So you start the pin with the round part down, tap it in place, and I like to set it, make sure it's below the line, because what we don't want is that sticking up at all. You just replaced your fire and pin retractor spring, folks, and yes, it's that easy. I want you to notice something about this while we're here. You push that firing pin forward, it does not even protrude out the front. See? It is centrifugal force of that hammer hitting that, all right? And that firing pin goes forward and strikes your primer. That's why these guns are so safe. And you'll find another video of me loading an 870, and do not try that at home, loading an 870 and beating the snot out of it with a mallet. I beat it so hard it knocked the trigger pins out, and that weapon did not just discharge. This is one of the reasons right here. Okay? Now, when the hammer, you got motion all the way through, now you see the firing pin come out and hit the primer. Okay? Alright, the only other part of this breech bolt is the extractor. And I showed you earlier in the video that the police and the express are the exact same breech bolt. Okay? There's no difference except for the extractor. The MIM extractor has a ridge across the back, and this does not have the ridge. I've never seen a MIM fail. I've never seen a MIM break. If you got a problem with MIM parts, don't drive your car, folks, because most of your brake parts are MIM. Don't fly, because when you look out the wing at that jet engine, them blades are MIM. But guys like to change this out for the solid steel. There's another video called extractor, how-to video on my website, will show you how to exchange that. If you have any questions about doing the bolt, or you're in the process of changing the firing pin retractor spring out and you get a problem, give me a call. I'll take your call. I'll talk you through it. We'll go to Skype and I'll show you or something, but we will get it done. Okay? Thank you.